praise the living God, dear heart. Thank you for joining me today on Holy Ghost Fire Talk. I am your host, Evangelist. And this is Pastor Ahav Shalom. Ahav Shalom, we simply giving God a peaceful house with his glory. Always remember who God's house. Our body actually is his house, his dwelling place, his temple, his tabernacle, his tent. And you know what? He's not going to coexist with demons in his house. I know paranormal investigators, psychics, teachers, people to coexist with demons in their dwelling place, their tent, their tabernacle, their house. Not so with the Holy Ghost. He just don't want part of us. He wants all of us. He just don't want to be living in our spirit while devil is reigning and ruling in the will, the mind, the emotions, and the body. No, Jesus wants the whole house. And in house alone, we remind you of that truth. And also, dear heart, when you need help in casting those devils out of God's house, we're here to help you in Jesus' name. Just go to the website, thechildrenmike.org/deliverance, and follow those instructions. But today is a live broadcast on Holy Ghost Fire Talk, in which I do teaching from the Word of the Living God. Scripture reference I'm using today is 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter. And our topic is the greatest is love. Regardless of what we do for the Lord, the greatest is love. We cannot do anything without love. Now, first of all, who is love? We need to get that straightened out. Well, God is love. If God is in us, then love is in us, then we will love one another. Praise the living God. So we praise and we thank God for his living word. He lives in us, dear Lord. And he wants us to love one another. No, we can tell a person, I love you, but the proof, as they say in the pudding, the proof is in the doing. We must show others that we love them. So it says in verse 1, chapter 13 of 1 Corinthians, though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, so I may be fluent in many languages naturally or supernaturally, and have not charity, which is love for one another. You know, we say we love God, but when it comes down to loving others, especially our enemies, because the Lord told us to love our enemies. He said, I am become a sounding brass. Have you ever heard sounding brass? Sounding brass sounds terrible. It's dead. Or a tinkling cymbal. You see a person thinking they know how to beat those cymbals, and that sound just irritates your ears. Without love, dear, whatever we do for the Lord, without love, that's how we sound to God. And verse 2 says, and though I have the gift of prophecy, I can go around prophesying and understand all mysteries. I can interpret your dreams, your visions, and whatever mystery you may have, and all knowledge, I may have all knowledge, and though I have all faith to believe whatever, so that I can remove mountains. My faith is so strong it removes mountains. But if I have not charity, which is love, I am nothing. So this shows us we can have all these gifts and lack love for one another. I remember when I first started out as a young girl speaking the word of God, because Pastor always wanted to get up and share about what he had just taught, which I hated to do, but he insisted. So I would get up and do it. As time went on, years went by, and I continued to do it, the Lord spoke to me one day. He said, Terry, you don't love my children. I'm like, huh? He said, No, you don't love him. Yes, I do. No, you do not. You beat him up. And when he said that, I just dropped my head. He said, now you remember, Terry, when you was a little girl, you and your uncle, your step-grandfather told you and your uncle to go feed the chickens. Well, you and your uncle did not want to feed those chickens. So since you had to feed those chickens, even though you didn't want to, you fed them. But you notice that when you fed the chicken, y'all notice that the chicken won't eat it. And you and your uncle got mad that you had to take your time and feed the chicken like your step-grandfather said, and they're not eating. You got so mad that your uncle took switches and started beating the chickens. I said, yeah, I remember that. What did your step-grandfather do to y'all after he took those same switches and beat us with? He said, well, Terry, that's how you're doing my children with my word. You're using my word, but in your heart, you are actually force-feeding them. You are beating them. And that is not love. You're not speaking from a heart of love to them. I say, yes, Lord, forgive me. Help me to love your dear children. So, dear, again, we can be gifted in many areas, but we don't have love for one another. You know, speak in love, act in love for one another. Even when it comes down to correction or rebuking someone, it's in love, love in the heart. Even though outwardly they may accuse you of being harsh, but inwardly it's love. It's love. Praise the living God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So we must love one another, because regardless of all those gifts, without love, it's not going to profit us nothing. Four say, charity suffers long. Love suffers long. Love, that is God. Remember who is love? It's God. We're going to suffer. When we do right, we're gonna reap good benefit, but we're going to suffer too. Because there are going to be those who don't like it. But you still have to love them. Charity suffers long. That means charity is patient. Love is patient. It's patient. It's like God is patient with us. We'll be patient with us. And in this ministry of deliverance, the heart, I have to ask the Lord to give me patience with his dear children. I see why Moses and God kept flip-flopping saying, Your children. Because I'm telling you, it takes the love of God in our heart to be patient with those who is half-heartedly seeking and pleasing God. But love suffers long. I mean, love is patient and is kind. Love is kind. It's not rude. Now, I'm not talking about someone accusing you of being rude when you know in your heart you're not. But the rudeness that's coming from the heart, you know you're rude from the heart. I speak to a man of people, and I pick up that rudeness, and I just look at them. And I'm talking about Christians. I expect that from sinners, but they don't serve God. But from Christians, no. That's when it really bothers you. Very rude. That's not love. Charity envieth not. Charity doesn't envy. It doesn't get jealous. You know, when someone rejoices, love, charity rejoices. I remember coming up and my friends would tell me how they got this and got that, was blessed, and there I was in lack. Lord said, Terry, rejoice with them. Act like it was you that got that blessing. As you continue to do that, then your blessing will manifest. And I learned as a young girl to do that, and I did that. And lo and behold, sure enough, my blessing manifested. Don't be envious and jealous and unkind and because you see someone else is blessed. You know, act like it's you. Praise God. Thank God. Rejoice with them. Act like it's you. And God will bless you. That's what charity love does. The greatest is love. Charity vaunteth not itself. It's not puffed up. Love cherishes, don't bring attention to itself. It don't decorate itself. In other words, all trying to make itself look good, look nice. Dress somebody else up for a change. You dress yourself up all the time. Go dress somebody else up. Go ask the Holy Spirit to lead you and guide you so you can go dress up. Never forget, many, many years ago, my family and I was in lack, and I didn't have no clothes haul in it. Couldn't get my hair done, and I said, Lord, if I know these people looking at me wearing the same thing over and over, and my hair, I said, bless me to get some clothes, get an outfit or something in my hair done. Well, look, lo and behold, not too long after that, young lady in the church said, Terry, I said, I want to bless you. I said, you do? She said, yes. She said, I want to take you and buy you an outfit and get your hair done. I said, thank you. You see, now that's love. That's charity. She just didn't care about vaunting or decorating herself, making herself look good. She thought about God's servant. She listened to the voice of the Holy Ghost. Go and bless Sister King, Sister Terry. Charity vaunteth not itself, is not puffed up. Does not behave itself unseemly. It does not. It seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, and think no evil. No, charity, love, it is not easily provoked. It's not easy to get angry. Not charity, not love. Remember who do charity, who love? That is God. And it don't think evil. You don't think evil, especially of a person. Man, you got to be careful about that. These spirits, they love to cause you to think it evil of somebody. You know, I have a WhatsApp group, and you know, I post a post, the demon tell you, Evangelist King talking about you. That's why she put it up there. She's talking about you, even on Facebook. She's talking about you. I even had people say, you talking about me? No, but maybe the Holy Ghost is. And it said, a shoe fit, you wear it. See, that person lacked love. That person lacked love. Why? Because they think it evil. Charity, love, thinketh no evil. You know, the Holy Ghost in us is not suspicious. So therefore, we won't be suspicious one of another. No. Holy Ghost knows, praise the living God. Sixth say, rejoice not in iniquity, but rejoice in the truth. Love, charity. Don't rejoice in sin. Don't rejoice when someone do something wrong. Or there's maybe a post circulating on Facebook that's putting down your brother and sister. You know, you don't go sharing something like that. If you share it, then you're rejoicing over it. So that means you lack love. You lack charity. You lack pleasing God. Because it don't rejoice in it. It should make you angry to see such posts about God's dear children. But charity and love rejoice in the truth. Rejoice in the truth. So therefore, on Facebook, social media, we share the truth. Many times, God, dear children, is not sharing truth on Facebook. Again, they share those lies. They share those lies because they rejoice in sin, rejoice in iniquity. Remember now, without love, it profits us nothing. Actually, without God, it profits us nothing. Seven say, charity beareth all things. Believe all things, hope all things, endure all things. You know, that's always my prayer to God. Help me to bear and endure all things. All things, Lord. The Lord only knows what it's going to take to perfect our faith, our trust in Him. What it's going to take for God to do in my life may be different than what it's going to take for God to do in your life. So the best thing for us to do is say the prayer, Lord, help me to bear it and do all things, because I know it's for my good. That's love. That's charity. They don't complain. Why am I going through this? What have I done for this to happen to me? No, charity, love doesn't say that. Say, Lord, help me to endure and bear all things. Charity never fails. Love never fails. God never fails. So do these songs that come out and say, God, you never fail me, don't say that other part yet. Ain't no such thing as you never fail me yet, because charity never fails. So just say, Lord, you never fail. Ain't you heard such songs? I heard numerous songs, nice songs too. But then they put that yet up there. I'm like, yeah, keep that yet out, because he can't. The word of God just tells us charity, love, who is God, never fail. So we don't have to put that yet up there. But rather there'll be prophecy, they shall fail. Why? Because they shall come to a pass. Whether there be tongue, they shall see, because it will stop. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away, because it will have fulfilled its purpose. Everything is going to fall but charity, love, who is God. But don't you know we better put our trust in the one who never fails us? And again, don't put that yet up there. Praise the living God. 9 says, for we know in part and we prophesy in part. We don't know everything. God only revealed to us a part, a piece, a fragmentary part, a piece of his wisdom, of his knowledge. The longer we're on this earth, we only know in part, we prophesy in part. That's the reason why sometimes God will only give us one little word. Ponder over that word. Sometimes he gives you a song, and the song only have about 4 words to it. Well, that's a sufficient enough. Praise the living God. Sing it. Sing that song with just those 4 lyrics. As you show God faithfulness to him, he'll give you more lyrics. Same thing with his word. He may give us one word. You hear one word coming up out of your spirit. You know, I remember the first time that happened to me and this person in the church we were attending. He was a deacon. I've been a deacon. He wanted to borrow my husband's ladder. My husband was home, so my husband told me he was coming. So he came. And when he came, the word respect just came up out of my spirit. I heard the Lord say respect. And I looked at him. I said, I heard the word respect. And he looked at me. And when I told him that, he got angry with me. Just that one word, respect. You know why? Because when I said the word respect, the Lord let him know what I was referring to. Then the Lord told me what he was referring to. Lord, when I saw that anger in him, the Lord told me, respect. He said, I'm telling him he needs to respect his wife. He's not respecting his wife. That's what the Lord told him. But he did not know the Lord told me what he told him. But that one word came up, respect, so I spoke it. I heard the Lord say, respect. And he got upset with me. And sure enough, Jehovah, a little after that, the Lord told me he was tearing. He just told his wife, gave me a word of knowledge. He said, just told his wife not have anything to do with you because you weren't right. I said, okay, Lord. You know, after the Lord told me that, it wasn't about a couple of minutes, my phone rang, and it was his wife crying. And she said, she was crying, she said, Tara, she said, my husband just told me I have nothing else to do with you, but I don't want to, because we were friends. I said, look, obey your husband. Physically, don't have nothing to do with me, but in your heart, he cannot stop it. Okay? She said, okay. and that was that. See, that's love. You see how love works, and we give love a chance. You know, a lot of times we butt in with our injections, poison everybody, yourself and those who happen to be listening, not because someone mistreated you, did you wrong. Charity, love, suffers long, and is kind. 10 say, but when that which is perfect is come, then that which imports shall be done away. It doesn't come a time where that which is perfect is come, and that's when we leave this earth. And that which imports shall be done away. And there'll be no more mystery, no more secret, because the truth will be totally known, dear heart, when we leave this earth. Oh, what a glorious time. 11 says, when I was a child, I spake as a child, I understood as a child, I thought as a child, but when I became a man or woman, I put away childish things, supposed to be. And when we were little children, we did childish things. When we became a man or woman, God only made male and female. Then we put those childish things away, supposed to put those childish things away. So 12 says, for now we see through the glass darkly. You know, it's like we looking through a glass darkly because we only can see in part. But then face to face. And now I know in part, but then shall I know even as I am also am known. That day will come. Again, that's when we leave this earth. That's why God don't work through just one person. He works through people. 13 say, and now abideth faith, hope, charity. These three, faith, hope, and charity. But the greatest of them all, or the greatest of these, is charity, which is love. Even though not charity is the greatest, which is love, we still need faith and hope. We hold on to faith, and we hold on to hope. But the greatest is love. The greatest is love. The greatest is charity. Praise the living God. Remember, the greatest is love. Love one another, saith the Lord. Love one another as Christ Jesus has loved us. Show that we love one another. Do unto others as we would have them do unto us. Render evil with good. I looked down at a little young girl. I said, render evil with good. I said, yeah. He said, well, someone mistreats you, you do good to them. That's how you pile coals on their own head. And then I would do that. They mistreat me. Many times I would hear my so-called friends talk about me. I would hear them. They don't know it. And I never let them know. Even family members, I would hear them talking about me. Even church members, the pastor, the first lady, church people. I would hear them talking about me. Not good thing, but I act like I never heard. They never knew to this day that I ever heard. Family member too, my loved one. Remember, you may be speaking in tongues, but if you don't have love, it profits you nothing. You can speak in tongues if you don't show love for your parents, for your spouse, for your children, for others. You know, they will turn their nose at you, up at you and count you as nothing. They won't even listen to you. But yet, here you speaking in tongues. So without love, without charity, it profits you nothing. So love one another through Christ Jesus. All right? Praise the living God. Now start.
Praise the living God, dear heart. Amen. Thank God for the teaching of his word. He is greatly to be praised. Remember, the greatest is love. Whatever you do, let you do it through love. Loving one another as Christ has loved us. That's important. Jesus gave his life for mankind because of love. The Father loved the world so much that he gave his unbegotten Son. That whosoever believes on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. So Christ died for us because he loved us. So the same Christ Jesus is in us, we will show love one for another. That includes our enemies. Includes our enemies. Praise the living God. Amen. Again, thank you for tuning into this live broadcast of Holy Ghost Fire Talk. I'm back after a lengthy period of time of being away. Praise God. Thank God for your prayer, keeping me up in prayer. You know, I have learned due to what I've been going through, the importance of the prayer of the saints on earth. Now, the saints in heaven always pray for us, but the saints on earth, it makes a difference when they pray for you. And I thank God for your prayer. Your prayer, my prayer, my family prayer, have kept me on this earth a little longer because my work is not completed yet. And I just thank God for you. Never think things that you do for the Lord, regardless how small it is, that it is insignificant. Dear heart, it is not. That's why we live by faith. We walk by faith. We justify by faith. We must believe God's word. Praise the living God. Holy Ghost Fire Talk, live broadcast on Monday, Friday at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. If you want to tune in, you have to go to the website, thechildrenlight.org/radio, and you see the instructions on how to tune in. Now, today, I have two people who called in. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to unmute you just to see if you have any questions pertaining only to the message, okay? If you don't have any questions, you say, Vance King, I don't have any questions, okay? And I want to give you that opportunity since you took the time to call in to the host. So I'm going to unmute 8539. So 8539, do you have any questions pertaining to the message?
Oh, no, I don't have a question.
Praise God. Thank you for tuning into the live broadcast, okay?
Thank you.
Praise God. Okay, I'm going to unmute 0902. Do you have any question pertaining to the message?
No, Evangelist King, I don't have any questions, but I did enjoy the message.
Yeah, thank you. I recognize this more, Sister Lisa. thank you, Sister Lisa, for tuning in. Praise God. See, dear heart, there's a difference when, you know, when people who contact me and they keep that relationship. If you keep that relationship, I come familiar with you in your voice. So when I hear you, I know who you are. But if you don't form any type of relationship with me, then I cannot get to know who you are, and I cannot get to know who your boy, know your boy. Thank you, Holy Spirit. That's why the Holy Spirit just said we need that relationship with Jesus Christ. When we have that relationship with Jesus Christ, then we will know his voice. We won't be confused. His voice is his word. Now we hold that relationship with the Lord. It's through his word. So when we hear his word, we hear his voice, we know his voice. We recognize his voice. We follow his voice. Praise the living God. So I want to thank my two dear sisters for tuning into the live broadcast, because when you tune into the live broadcast, it does give me encouragement. It encouraged me, okay? And I thank you all who listen to the archive. So if you listen to the archive, come on over to the live broadcast, Monday, Friday at 12 noon, Eastern Standard Time, Holy Ghost Fire Talk. Also, Shalom Morning Prayer on Tuesday mornings at 8 a.m. Okay, that's the live broadcast. Where I bring a light teaching at the end, I unmute everybody, and you can join in corporate prayer. If you're at work, you just make sure on your end, you just mute yourself, okay? Praise God. All right, now, again, thank you for your prayers and continue to pray my strength in the Lord. One prophecy, man of God, hope for this year is a year of strength. I said, Lord, I'm grabbing hold of that prophecy because I need that. That's physical and that spiritual strength. And I'm gradually seeing the Lord just giving my body strength each and every day. So continue to upkeep us in prayer as I always continue to keep all those that God sent to this ministry. They are always in my heart where I intercede and pray for them. Okay? So continue to have a blessed day in Jesus' name. Shalom.